Hello students, today we will read the chapter number 3, Deep Water. This chapter is written by William O. Douglas and he was born in Maine, Minnesota. And he, in this chapter, which is taken from Of Men and Mountains by William O. Douglas, he shares his experience of fear of water. As he just wants to share the concept of fear and how to overcome that fear. We all, everybody in this life has a fear in his life. But what is the main thing? We can't live with that fear forever. So the main need is to overcome that fear. William O. Douglas, he was frightened of water. He hated water when he was a small boy. But when he understood that he could not live with this fear, then he just made his mind to overcome that fear. And here in this chapter, he shares the same experience. He reveals as a young boy how he was nearly drowned in a swimming pool. Kaise wo kareeb kareeb doobne wala tha ek swimming pool mein. In this essay, he talks about the fear of water and thereafter, what happened after then, how he finally overcame it. Notice how the autobiographical part of the selection is used. So he shares his autobiographical part to support the discussion of fear. So we should overcome our fear, and the main thing to overcome our fear is to face the fear. So the chapter starts with the line, "It happened when I was 10. So the narrator, the writer, William O. Douglas, he shares, he tells you that it had happened when he was 10 or 11 years old. So he shares an experience when he was a small boy of 10 or 11. "I had decided to learn to swim. There was a pool at the YMCA in Yakima." So Yakima is a river. It is a tributary river of Columbia River in USA. And YMCA was a club which was in America, and its full form is Young Men's Christian Association. So there was a pool at YMCA in Yakima that offered exactly the opportunity. As William O. Douglas, he wanted to learn swimming, so he went to the pool which was at the YMCA. What is the full form of YMCA? Young Men's Christian Association. The Yakima River was treacherous. Treacherous means which is so dangerous. Mother continually warned against it, as he wanted to learn swimming. So his mother always, most of the time, continuously warned against it, that it was so dangerous, and kept fresh in mind the details of each drowning in the river. And she kept fresh in his mind about the latest drowning in the river. As every mother is afraid and every mother is so caring about her children. But the YMCA pool was safe. He's talking about the YMCA pool, which was at YMCA, so it was safe. The river was treacherous because river's water is full of spirit, and that's why it cannot be said where it is so deep, etc. It was only 2 or 3 feet deep at the shallow end. So YMCA pool was safe, and it was only 2 or 3 feet deep at the shallow end. Shallow जो होता है, जो जहाँ से पानी दिखाई देता है, जो मतलब जहाँ से show हो रहा होता है पानी. And while it was 9 feet deep at the other, and on the other side it was 9 feet deep. The drop was gradual. The drop was slow. "I got a pair of water wings." So as he wanted to learn swimming, so he went to YMCA. He went to the swimming pool at YMCA, and because it was safe, and he got a pair of wings, water wings, to learn swimming, and went to the pool because he wanted to learn swimming. "I hated to walk naked into it." Here is a graph also given of that river, Yakima River. And Yakima River is a tributary river of Columbia River. Okay, students? You can see the map here. So, William O. Douglas, he tells that he was feeling ashamed when he entered or when he went to the pool naked and show my skinny legs. So, he felt very embarrassed when as to show his skinny legs. Skinny means weak, thin. But I subdued my pride, but he collected his pride, his strength, and did it. And he just went to there and started learning. From the beginning, however, I had an aversion. Aversion means hate. Earlier, he is telling that he, when he was 10 or 11 years old, he was so afraid of water. But now he is talking about the time when he was 3 or 4 years old. So this is the concept of fear is not the beginning when he was 10 or 11 years old. Even he started hating water when he was just 3 or 4. Actually, what happened to him? He had an aversion. He started hating to the water when I was in it. He was saying that when he was in water, he started hating. This started when I was 3 or 4 years old. When William Douglas was 3 or 4 years old, he started hating water. He tells that his father took him to the beach in California. So he says, my father took me to the beach in California. California is a big city in USA. He and I stood together in the surf. William Douglas and his father, they were standing in the surf, in the water of sea. I hung on to him, yet the waves knocked me down. When they were standing there in the surf and he was hung on to his father, then waves knocked him down. जो वेव्स थी उसने उन्होंने उसको गिरा दिया एंड स्वेप्ट ओवर हिम आई वॉज बरीड इन वाटर विलियम डगलस वॉज बरीड इन वाटर माई ब्रीथ वॉज गॉन ही वॉज नॉट एबल टू टेक ब्रीथ आई वॉज फ्राइटेंड फादर लाफ्ड एंड ही वॉज वेरी मच फ्राइटेंड बिकॉज ही वॉज जस्ट अ चाइल्ड एंड एज द वेव्स नॉक्ड हिम ओवर एंड स्वेप्ट ओवर हिम सो ही वॉज वेरी मच अफ्रेड. His father started laughing. Father laughed. But there was terror in my heart at the overpowering force of the waves. But after that, he developed a terror in his heart. Because those waves overpowered him. Un waves ne kya kiya? Uske upar kabu pa liya. Dar gaya woh jada. He was a small kid. My introduction to the YMC swimming pool revived unpleasant memories and stirred childish fear. Now we come back to the time when he was 10 or 11 years old, when he went to YMC swimming pool. Okay? Earlier he hated water because when he was 3 or 4 because he went to a Californian beach with his father. And there he was buried in water. That's why he was frightened. But now, when he became 10 or 11 years old, he made his mind to learn swimming and went to YMCA swimming pool because it was safe. So, he collected his strength and went there. So, my introduction to the YMCA swimming pool revived unpleasant memories. So, the introduction to the YMCA, when he went to YMCA swimming pool, then this experience recalled his unpleasant, his hateful memories and stirred childish fear. And he started feeling that childish fear again, the fear of water. But in a little while, I gathered confidence. But after some time, he gathered confidence. He got confident that he could do that. I paddled with my new water wings, watching the other boys and trying to learn by aping them. Aping means imitating, copying. So he paddled. Paddled means to do the activity in water. So with new water wings, he started doing activity in water. And with other boys, he started learning by coping them. I did this 2 or 3 times on different days and was just beginning to feel at ease in the water when the misadventure happened. Underline this phrase, the misadventure happened. There are 2 facts. When he was 3 or 4 years old, he developed an aversion. He developed a dislike to water. When he was 10 or 11 years old, the misadventure happened to him. So there will be 2 events. The first one, when he was 3 or 4 years old, he started hitting water, but he developed more fear when he became 10 or 11, when he was 10 or 11 years old, and then a misadventure happened to him. When he was in water pool, then he started learning swimming, and he did it. He did those activities 2 or 3 times on different days, and he was just feeling comfortable in water. He started feeling ease. Ease means easy in the water, and just after that, misadventure happened to him. I went to the pool when no one else was there. He says that he went to the pool when no one else was there. Why? Because he was so skinny. That's why he felt ashamed of. The place was quiet. Actually, what happened? By how the misadventure happened? One day when he went to the pool, the place was quiet. The water was still. As the place was quiet, no one was there. So water was also still. Pani jo tha, wo sthir tha. And the tiled bottom was as white and clean as a bathtub. So as it seemed in a bathtub, water seemed in a bathtub, it was just like that. The bottom was so white because there are tiles in the bottom of the swimming pool. I was timid about going in alone. He timid means coward. So he was feeling very much timid to go alone in the pool because he was afraid of water. So I sat on the side of the pool to wait for others. That's why he sat on the side of the pool to wait for others. That other when other people will come, other boys will come, then he will go inside the pool. I had not been there long when in came a big bruiser of a boy. Big bruiser. Bruiser boy means a boy who has a good physique. So he had not been there long. Ab isko jyada time bhi nahi hua tha. Suddenly a big bruiser boy came there. Probably 18 years old. That boy was about 18 years. He had thick hair on his chest. He was young. He was a beautiful physical specimen. Specimen means sample. So he was an example of good physique. With legs and arms that showed rippling muscles. He had rippling muscles. Rippling means jo bahut sudol hoti hai, achhi. Good physique. जिसकी होती है उसकी जो हाथ पैर होते हैं जिस तरह के. He yelled. Yelled means cried. He yelled, "Hi skinny, how would you like to be ducked?" He called him skinny because the narrator was so thin and weak. "How would you like to be ducked? डुबकी लगाना चाहोगे?" He just told that in a joking manner. With that, he picked me up and tossed me into the deep end. And after that, just after saying so, he picked him up and tossed him into the deep end of the swimming pool. I landed in a sitting position, swallowed water, and went at once to the bottom. Then the narrator, William O. Douglas, he landed in a sitting position because he was sitting on the edge of the pool and the boy picked him up and tossed him. So he landed in the same position, sitting position. This is so funny. Swallowed water because suddenly it happened. So he swallowed water because he was not a good swimmer. He didn't know how to treat it. And went at once to the bottom. And he at once went to the bottom of the pool. I was frightened, but not yet frightened out of my wits. Wits means, you can say, my wits means hosh havas jo hote hain, hosh mein. But not yet frightened. Even he was very much frightened, but not much frightened that he was out of his wits. On the way down, I planned. When he just went to the bottom, suddenly, quickly, then he planned. What was his plan? that when my feet hit the bottom, I would make a big jump, come to the surface, lie flat on it, and paddle to the edge of the pool. These lines are very important, okay? Underline them. This is the main idea. This is the main point. It was a plan of the narrator. He would apply this plan many times. So what was his plan? Then when his feet would hit the bottom, he would make a big jump, come to the surface of the water, lie flat on it, and paddle and do the activity. He will swim and will come to the edge of the pool. It was his plan. But how can this plan be successful when it happens to a good swimmer? But the narrator, he was not a swimmer. He didn't know swimming. So what will happen to it? We'll see. It seemed a long way down. When he went to the bottom, it seemed that it was a very long way to go down. Those 9 feet, because it was only 9 feet deep. Those 9 feet were more like 90 for him. And before I touched bottom, my lungs were ready to burst. Before touching the bottom of the pool, his lungs started bursting. Bursting means explode. He was feeling heavy in lungs. But when my feet hit bottom, I summoned all my strength. But still he remembered his plan. When he touched the bottom, he summoned. Summon means call. So he called all his strength. He gathered all his strength, all his power, and made what I thought was a great spring. And he thought, he had to make a big jump upwards. I imagine I would bob to the surface like a cock. He thought that he would bob, he would jump like a surface, jump to the surface like a cock, like a spring. Instead, I came up slowly, but instead of that, he came up slowly, because whenever you enter in water, there is a power of water also. You can't do it with the same pressure as you think. I opened my eyes and saw nothing. He opened his eyes and saw nothing except the water. Come to the next page. So he didn't see anything but water, because he was still in water. Water that had a dirty yellow tinge. Tinge means glimpse. Because he was in water, so he could see a yellow, dirty glimpse of water. I grew panicky. He was feeling nervous. Panicky means nervous. Nervous, feeling nervousness. I reached up as if to grab a rope. He tried to reach a rope, and his hands clutched only at water. But he could clutch only water, because he was in water itself and nothing was there to catch. I was suffocating. I tried to yell, but no sound came out. He was feeling suffocating. Dam ghut raha tha uska. He was feeling very suffocating. He tried to call, but no sound came out from his mouth. Then my eyes and nose came out of water. Then suddenly his eyes and nose came out of water, but not my mouth, but not his mouth, because as he made a jump, but not with much pressure, so his eyes and nose came out, but not his mouth. So he did not came out completely. I flailed at the surface. He just started beating his legs and body on surface of the water, not of the pool, but of the water. Swallowed and choked, but he could swallow water only, and choked, he could not breathe. I tried to bring my legs up, but they hung as dead weights. He tried to bring his legs up. He apne pair upar uthane ki usne koshish ki, but they hung as dead weights. Dead weights, weights means, weight means jo heavy, jo thing hoti hai, bhari vajan. Paralyzed, he was feeling paralyzed, rigid, heavy, hard. A great force was pulling me under. A great force of water was pulling him inside. I screamed, but only the water heard me. He tried to scream. He tried to call, for help, but only water heard him. I had started on the long journey back to the bottom of the pool, and this time again he had to go to the bottom of the pool because nothing was there to catch, nothing was there to clutch, so and no one was there to help him. So he had to go to the water again. Again, it was a long journey for him because he was feeling suffocating. He was feeling very much afraid. We'll continue in the next video. Thank you.